Today, we take electricity for granted, like air. However, in large part of the world, broad off-grid areas still exist. 60% of Africans have no access to electricity, while 22% of Asia's population still lives in off-grid areas. We also find many weak grid areas, such as India, where people suffer from power failure and high electricity prices. The lack of electricity use leads to serious social problems, such as poverty and social divisions, but also raises concerns about environmental sustainability and social resilience. Expansion of electricity use can help alleviate these problems and concerns. So, how can electricity use be expanded in developing countries? We believe the keys lies in the integration of power and IT spheres by introducing bottom-up control technologies implemented in IT sector to power sector. It will be possible to expand power supply much more efficiently and cheaply than currently possible. This change is like moving from the planned economy of communist states to the capital market, free market of capitalist world. But in order to bring about this change, we have to decentralize power services. Unfortunately, it is not easy to realize this change due to a number of barriers that stand in the way. At least four, to be specific. The first one is the resistance to new technology. Society don't easily accept new technology and concept because they are difficult to understand and pose various risks. The second barrier is the delay in social system reforms. Power industry regulations are a typical example. IT cannot make a difference under the top-down social system. In developing countries, barriers related to social acceptance and regulations are relatively low. However, the lack of the planning capability and the stability of the government forms a third barrier. The fourth barrier is the lack of the imagination, crucial to designing a new business model. Constructing a new business model compatible with a new paradigm requires creative individuals who are familiar with the new technology and the emerging market. The University of Tokyo is helping to realize the integration of power and IT sectors in developing countries. I would like to explain two examples of how we are using bottom-up control technologies to expand power supply efficiently in developing countries. First example is the microgrid construction in Myanmar. Myanmar, you know, has attracted global attention for its growth potential. However, 72% of the population still lives in off-grid areas, even though they have abundant natural resources such as hydro and biomass. The microgrid construction is much more cheaper than the extension of megagrid from urban areas to farming villages. It is also possible to reduce investment and operational cost using IT to control microgrid efficiently. So we are supporting to establish essential social system, grid planning, as well as the human capital development in Myanmar. Next example is Kenya. In Kenya, more than 17% of the population now use mobile phone. However, one-time cost of charging a mobile phone is extremely high, at 20 cents in remote areas. Standalone charging systems are cheaper. However, the difficulty of billing users has been a major constraint. Our solar kiosk with digital grid technology enables remotely controlled billing systems. So we established a small company funded by venture capital last year, and to provide electricity in Kenya and Tanzania with our original idea of a business model and a new technology.